All right. So, hello everyone, and I am very, very excited to be with Dr. Bhargavi, our star of the day.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
So, to start with, what's your exact feeling right now?
Yeah, ma'am. I didn't expect it initially. So, now I initially felt the paper was tough, ma'am. That is why I couldn't accept. And then later on, then finally, I.
You got ranked too.
Yes, I checked it a lot of times.
Okay. And what was the parents' reaction?
Yeah, ma'am. They're very happy.
Obviously. Yeah. All right. So, I think it's a very joyful moment for yes. you, your parents, family, and for us also, because we are also a family, right?
Yes, yes.
So,
yes.
Okay. So, one thing I tend to start with, that you have managed to be, star bearer of this INICT. How did you manage? Because, you know, the things were not good. There was a lot of, cancellations, lot of negativity, lot of sickness. So obviously, maintaining the pace, especially in these months, were quite difficult. So how did you manage?
First of all, I took care that I was safe at home. I didn't go out at all, because I didn't want to contract infection and then waste about 2 to 4 weeks. So I thought I'll stay at home. So I stayed at home for the past 1 year. And then whenever I felt low, I would talk to my friends. We would study together for a few hours per week. And that kept me going.
Yeah, I think a good family and friends at this moment, their support is very, very important. And we all are blessed to have a good family. So yes, that's a very important thing. But, when we are all prepared for examination and then suddenly news comes just 1.5 day before, that that feeling is but natural. And I won't say that somebody may have a different response. So everybody is so disturbed at that time. So what kept you going at that time? What kept you motivated at that time?
Yes, ma'am. That is why I actually selected the Bhartiya Test and Discussion series, to be honest, because after the last INICT, as I went through the counseling process, I thought I was losing track. And that is why I thought I should join a test and discussion for sure to get back. And definitely Bhartiya Test and Discussion helped in that, ma'am. I came back to my study mood and I started studying, ma'am. Yes, so I think it's important.
Yes. Please.
Yeah, it's important to join a test and discussion series whenever you feel you're not into your plan, you're not able to follow your plan.
Yeah, so I think whenever you have your own strategy, it is best to follow that. But once you are out of track and you do not have any plans, you don't have any strategy, then sticking to this standard plan is also a good idea. And I think if you follow, keep on following that, you don't have to bother what to study next, because I think during the NEET PG preparation, this is again a problem, what to study next, how to maintain that circle of 19 subjects. So were you regular in giving test?
Yes, ma'am, but after initially I saw only the videos, only after INICT, the first INICT, that is when I understood the importance of subject-wise test. And that was a correct time when I entered into Bhartiya TNP. So I felt it's important. Giving subject test regularly is very important. And when you do it all alone, I feel we do not continue it. We give 5 to 6 tests and then we feel, I have to give a GET or something. But when you enroll into some program, I feel you're forced to study that subject completely, give the test, analyze, and see if you're strong or no. So, yes. Yeah.
That we covered in the TNT, we try to keep both conceptual questions, the clinical scenario questions, or the image based questions. They were quite similar to the actual exam that you got. And does it help you in your preparation?
Yes, ma'am. I actually enrolled into the NEET TNT in Bhartiya. But to be honest, all the questions were very, very clinical and they were extremely useful for the INICT exam. All of them were of the same level. Even those NEET questions were up to INICT level. So it was very useful, ma'am. All the clinical questions. And I watched the discussion videos also. Whichever subject I felt I was weak at, I watched the subjects, and others I did not watch. So the discussions were really useful, ma'am.
Because, you know, one very important goal when we keep the test in discussion is to give the exact simulating environment to the student. So yes. There is no use keeping that level low, because sometimes, you know, students get feel low also that we are getting lesser score in this TND sessions, or if they are getting the lesser scores in the GT. So we always tell them that, see, you are going to get at par or even lesser than this level, and you will feel better when you get a better score there in comparison to these, rather than the reverse. So yes. That was there. I think you could relate with it very well. All right. So what about your starting phase? How did you, were you punctual during your third years, and did you read the textbooks? What was the main pattern of reading that time?
We read, ma'am, we read for our exams purpose. We never read for entrance purpose. Entrance preparation started only last year. After my internship, I started my entrance preparation. Before that, it was just for our prof exams.
All right. So, did you believe in reading the textbook?
Extra. Somewhere you have studied, somewhere will definitely help. So, I think it's important.
So, not I'll ask you a personal question, that which textbooks did you read
in my UG days, ma'am?
Yes, yes.
UG days, most of it were Indian authors. But for PATH, mm-hmm. we were asked to read Robbins. So we read Robbins. For medicine, we read Davidson. For surgery, mm-hmm. we read Indian authors only.
You have gone on mute. You have what? Gone on. Yeah. Could you please repeat this because you were on mute? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now it's okay.
Yes, ma'am. All the textbooks were advised by our seniors, ma'am. Whatever they said, we had to follow. And a few subjects were really useful, like Robbins for PATH was really useful, all the images. Mm-hmm. When we see it now during our entrance preparation, nothing seems very new. It seems mm-hmm. familiar. So mm-hmm. subjects mm-hmm. like those, and even Davidson, and the rest were all Indian authors, ma'am.
All right. So which book did you use for Ofta?
Ofta, we used Purana.
Quran. Okay. So you did not try to read the Parsons, I think.
I got Parsons. But as
you are, yeah. I think this is a common thing that people do buy both Quran and the Parsons. They read the Quran and Parsons keep on, you know, shining over the desk.
Yes, yes, definitely.
And that is the reason that I have started the Parsons series. So yes, that people can get the confidence of reading it, and it does not just shine on their tables. Yes, Robbins and Davidson or Harrison's, people try to read. Some of them are able to complete. I do not know if everyone is able to complete it cover to cover.
We were asked to read only Davidson.
Davidson, and it works also quite well, I think.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Were you giving the GTs also?
Yes, ma'am. I gave GTs like once in 2 weeks or 3 weeks. I was not very frequent. Only for the last 1 month, I gave one GT every 10 days. That's it.
All right. So how did you feel that like test and discussions, you are already saying that it helped you, and the quality of the questions also helped you. So does this giving GTs added some extra edge to your preparation or not?
Definitely, ma'am. We try to realize what are our silly mistakes and try to avoid them. And especially test and discussion videos, I saw videos by Dr. J for surgery, and a lot of concepts became clear after that. A lot of protocols became clear after that. Mm-hmm. I saw a lot of videos by Vaidehi ma'am for OG medicine summaries, or I saw one video. So they're really useful. If you are a weak at a particular subject, you have to see the videos.
All right. So after you have given the exam also, did you felt that the questions that were there in the exam, you were having the same quality questions, all type of questions and all type of materials that was asked in this paper was covered in your test in any form, maybe in the test and discussion or maybe in the GTs?
Yes, ma'am. So many clinical questions. So that when you see it for the first time on the exam day, you shouldn't feel shocked. And I never felt that shock, because I've attended a lot of tests from Bhatia. All of them were entirely clinical. So yes, ma'am, definitely. It simulates it.
All right. So did you attempted this mock test also, INICT mock?
Yes, ma'am, I attended one INICT mock. Yeah.
All right. So do you feel that we could simulate the when you went to the classroom there?
Yes, ma'am. It was a moderate level paper and it's not very tough, not very easy, because sometimes we feel certain papers are very, very tough and you get demotivated. Yes. But here it was a balanced paper, ma'am.
And yes. I remember that we were having a talk on this, what to include in this INICT, because all the faculties are giving the high topics in their, subjects of this. But we definitely recommended that do include some of the previous recall questions also of the INICT. And I think that act as a booster, because this year you were having so many of recall questions, previous questions were there. Okay. Now, after giving this, what do you think is same for the upcoming NEET PG examination and what could be different? So because everybody is watching you people and they want to learn from you. Okay. So what are the important things that they should keep into their mind while having their journey for the last 45 days, because everybody was not fortunate enough to make good in this paper. So what are the do's and don'ts actually for the upcoming NEET PG paper?
Yes, ma'am. Notes are a must. You should at least revise it 2 times before your NEET exam. And GTs 1 per week should do. And you have to have a list of your previously asked questions from NEET papers, like how we do it for AIIMS. Before INICT exam, I had a list of important topics from AIIMS, because that is what you revise in the last 1 week. In the same way, you have to make a list for PYQs of NEET. And that is what you should revise in the last week. So when you have 45 days, I think 20 days for revision, and last 5 days you can do PYQs. Yeah.
All right. So, वैसे तो I don't feel that you have done any mistake. Your rank shows that. But anything after giving the paper, you felt that I should not have done this, or I should have done this also.
Yes, ma'am. I was always stuck with 2 options. So when people said it was easy, I was actually shocked, because I didn't find it very easy compared to last INICT. So that's why this was a shock to me, the result.
So what do you think how can you remove this confusion? Because this is a common problem. Out of the 4 options, most of the students get stuck in 2 options, and removing the 2 options is quite easy, but choosing the 1 option out of the 2 options becomes quite difficult. So what can be done in order to, overcome this problem?
Ma'am, I think sometimes logic works, sometimes it's just your guesswork. I really think sometimes you can't find out the answer because you haven't read it anywhere. From where will it come? Either based on logic
some
or
Googlies,
you just mark it.
I think some Googlies
were
also.
Yes, there are, for sure. Yes, ma'am. Yes, they were.
And one thing is that if you give more tests, like more practice, can you be more sure about your guesswork? Because sometimes, everybody's guesswork is not that good. And mind is saying something else, and your gut feeling says, no, it's not that. So their logic does not work. So does giving more of the test and, facing that agony of choosing the 1 from the 2 gives you more confidence in attempting such type of questions?
I really never concentrated on that aspect. I never concentrated much on that. All that I realized is if I give more GTs, I can cut down my silly mistakes. That's what I understood.
Yes.
Guesswork, I really didn't think about.
Yes, so that is one thing you cannot rely upon. But if you give more and more tests, then you tend to know that how to attempt these type of questions also, which you are not really very sure of. And I think this is a very small chunk of the questions that you are getting that way. Most of the questions will be topics and that we had been giving in the GTs and the TNTs, and you people were reading. What about the image-based session?
Yes, ma'am. I had the PDF. I went through the PDF before the exam and it helped. I went through ophthal images.
All right. So did you feel that any of the questions, any of the topics, any of the images that were means absolutely new and you were not exposed to those that
topics were definitely familiar. Only thing is that those options here and there, topics were okay. They were familiar.
Options were more tricky and more close.
Yes, all yes, right. Exactly.
Okay, so any special message that you would like to give to your juniors and your colleagues who are, banking upon the upcoming NEET PG 2021?
Yes, ma'am. I would just like to tell that almost all the top 500 or 300 who have written this exam, all of them have put in the same amount of hard work. Only thing that matters is your presence of mind and a little bit of luck what favors you. So don't get disheartened. Just revise and definitely you would succeed. Don't be obsessed also that even for this exam, I wasn't very obsessed that I want this exam for sure. I want to crack this. Take it light. Whatever happens, you have to face it at the end of the day because we have more real hurdles to face. So take it light, concentrate on your health and just give your best.
So I think a very wonderful and important piece of advice. Thank you so much, and once again, heartiest congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am.
And wish you all the very best for your upcoming examinations too.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you.